So I finally did it. I finally managed to add a colorway of the Foam Runners to my collection, and what an ordeal it has been. What are you saying, people? It's myself, Mr. Morrow. Welcome back to another video on my channel where we talk about trainers and streetwear. In today's video, we'll be looking at the Yeezy Foam Rnr in the Mist colorway. As always, before we get into this video, make sure you give this video a big thumbs up by liking this video, share this video with your friends, and subscribe to the channel, as it really does help me to continue making great content for you guys, and it keeps you updated with notifications so that you know when I drop new videos on this channel. So I finally did it. I finally managed to add a colorway of the Foam Rnrs to my collection, and what an ordeal it has been. It's an interesting one because despite the amount of negativity that these shoes receive and all of those comments that we see under some of the early release pictures of these shoes, every single drop these shoes seem to sell out almost immediately, and the resale prices for them are quite high, especially if we're looking at some of the colorways that released last year, and so it just doesn't really make sense. That being said, over the weekend we did see the release of both the Mist and the Stone Sage colorway, and they both released for the retail price of £75, and it seems from the comments and from some of the other reviews that I've seen people post that many people gravitated towards the Stone Sage colorway. However, I personally thought that that colorway was a little bit dull, and I personally prefer the warmer tone of the Mist colorway. So a few months back, I actually managed to secure a pair of the Foam Rnrs in the mineral blue colorway, and I'll be leaving a link above to that video, and that video gives a little bit more of a detailed look at the Foam Rnr itself. What I must say upon receiving these and trying these on again is that they are definitely very comfortable. Not as comfortable as my Foam Slides, however, they are definitely a very comfortable shoe to have around. One thing that I do have to admit, as I did admit earlier on in the video, is that I would have definitely been one of those people that would have been in the comment section just talking about how much I can't really take in this pair of shoes. However, as the time has gone on and I've seen different people wearing these shoes and I've seen the different fits they've managed to pull off, this is definitely a pair of sneakers that have grown on me. One thing that I must say is that I do defend the criticisms regarding the practicality of the shoe, especially living in London, where it is relatively cold, windy, and wet. This is definitely going to be a seasonal pair of shoes if I'm hoping to get a lot of use out of them in London, because it's just not practical. You won't really get any defense towards the rain or the wind. However, I do think this will be a great shoe to wear on planes, as it is quite comfortable and it's easy to slip on and off, and it will also be great on holiday when you are going to sunnier places. The Yeezy Foam Rnr in the Mist colorway comes in your standard Yeezy Foam Rnr box, which is completely plain on the outside of the box. Upon opening the box, you will see the foam written on the inner part of the lid, and we do have RNNR or Rnr on the base part of the box. Moving into the shoe, but starting with the sole, we do have the standard Foam Rnr sole, and if you see my other video, I do go into a little bit more detail regarding the sole and some of the design aspects of this shoe. It suffices to say here that the remainder of the shoe is covered in this Mist colorway, which personally for me is the best colorway in the Foam Rnr after the sand colorway. I just feel that these two neutral tones are very easy to wear, and you'll get a lot more fit than in comparison to some of the other colorways that have released. In terms of sizing, this is my only gripe with this shoe. Because I am normally a true half size, fitting into the shoe was a little bit difficult. The size 11 was just a little bit too small, but the size 12 does have a lot of space in the back for me, and I generally like my sneakers to fit quite snug. And so if you are a half size, you may find it a little bit spacious when buying this size up. And that's pretty much everything for the Yeezy Foam Rnr in the Mist colorway. Definitely not a shoe for everyone, but if you are a fan of the Foam Rnr, this is the best colorway to get after the Sand if you couldn't get your hands on the Sand colorway. Let me know if you found this video useful. Let me know if you managed to add a pair of Foam Rnrs from this weekend's drop in your collection. It's myself, Mr. Morrow. There'll be many more videos coming out soon. Remember to like, share this video with your friends, and subscribe to the channel.